Hi guys, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. This is the continuation to part 2. I will link part 2 of this video in description box below, and the link must also be appearing in the suggestion box. I'll link the part 1 of the same video as well. So please do watch those as well. So without further ado, let's get started on part 3. After all the required information has been collected for the piping design of the heat exchanger, the first step is to outline clearance and working space in front and around both ends of the exchanger. These working space should be kept clear of any piping and accessories to facilitate channel, shell cover and tube bundle removal, as well as maintenance and cleaning. Piping associated with heat exchangers should be routed as per general guidelines for layout. You can refer our video. The link is appearing on your screen. Moreover, I'll link the video in the description box below. The free space at the side of horizontal shell can be used for placement of control stations. The piping is elevated from grade to have a clearance of 300 mm from the grade level. Removable spools should be provided on the lines connected with the removable part of the exchangers for ease of maintenance. Locally mounted pressure and temperature indicators on exchanger nozzles on the shell or channel lines should be visible from grade or access platform. The steam lines connected to a header in the yard can be arranged on either side of the exchanger center line without increasing the pipe length. Cooling water lines, if underground, should run right under the lined up channel nozzles of all coolers. For stacked exchangers, the nozzles between the exchangers shall be connected by exchanger vendor. For other nozzles connected with external piping, elbow nozzles can be proposed to reduce the height of the stack. Some of the typical piping arrangements are horizontal reboilers and for vertical reboilers, as you can see on your screens. Now, let's talk about support location and the flexibility requirement for heat exchangers. General points should be taken care of while deciding the support location. Angles play a large role in determining the piping configuration for exchangers. It should be considered that in many cases, the location of anchors can be adjusted to accommodate a better piping design. This is applicable to both pipe anchors and exchange support anchors. Stress group recommendations should be followed to ensure minimum piping loads on nozzles of heat exchangers. Allowable nozzle loads. As per our standard nozzle loads of equipments, allowable nozzle load should be provided to mechanical department at inquiry inquisition stage of air coolers. Piping supports on vendor-provided structures should be avoided. If any of the client specification mentions for free flange displacement criteria, then supporting methodology shall be finalized accordingly at initial stage of project. In setting vertical reboilers, a number of options for method of support are possible, as shown in the figure below. The best choice for any given application will depend on the process requirement as well as the availability of space, type and weight of the equipment being used and the maintenance requirements for reboilers. Generally, pipe supports at shell and tube exchangers can be incorporated with the exchanger's support foundation and can be set upon the same foundation. This can save the expense of separate support foundations. Anchors set on such supports allow the pipe to grow with the exchanger instead of against it. However, stress recommendations, project specification shall govern this criteria. Flexibility requirement for high temperature and high pressure lines. As shown in the pic, there can be two arrangements possible to ensure flexibility requirement for high pressure and temperature lines. First is to provide loops in the piping layout as shown in alternative A, and other is to provide spring support on the central exchanger as shown on the alternative B. So that is it guys, I hope you liked the video. If you did, please hit the like button. For more such useful content, please hit the subscribe button. This will keep us motivated and also will notify you every time we post. Thank you so much. Please keep on watching. Bye-bye.